In this example, we'll take a look at determining the perimeter of an equilateral triangle given the height. And we're able to do this based upon the information we know about a 30-60-90 triangle, as we see here on the left. We normally label the sides of a 30-60-90 triangle as 1, 2, and square root 3 because the ratio of the sides stay constant, but we know that a 30-60-90 triangle can be any multiple of this triangle on the left. If we multiply each side by x, we have x as the shortest leg, 2x for the hypotenuse, and x square root 3 as the longer leg. So let's go ahead and take a look at our example. We want to determine the perimeter of this equilateral triangle given that the height is 6 square root 3. So we label the height as 6 square root 3 . Notice how it divides the equilateral triangle into two 30-60-90 triangles. This would be 30 degrees, this would be 60 degrees, and this is our right angle. So the longer leg of this 30-60-90 triangle has a length of 6 square root 3, and that corresponds to the side that's labeled x square root 3 on our more general reference triangle. So this tells us that x square root 3 must equal 6 square root 3. So if we solve this equation for x, we can use this to determine the length of each side of this equilateral triangle. Well, if we divide both sides by square root 3, we have x equals 6, which would tell us the length of the shorter leg of the 30-60-90 triangle, or 2 times x would give us the length of the hypotenuse. So if this side has a length of 2x, this side would also have a length of 2x, which would be 2 times 6, or 12 units. And because it's an equilateral triangle, all the sides would have a length of 12 units. So to determine the perimeter of this equilateral triangle, we just need to determine the sum of the length of the three sides. Well, 12 plus 12 plus 12, or 3 times 12, would give us a perimeter of 36 units. And that'll do it for this example.